As we mentioned, functional programming is all about composing values. We also mentioned that functions are values too. So not surprisingly, we can compose and combine them. In future lessons, we will look at composing values other than functions. But for now, let's focus on combining functions. As the name of our paradigm suggests, most of what we do in functional programming is composing functions. In this lesson, we'll look at the simplest way of composing functions, and later on, we will look into more complicated situations. Let's continue on our previous example in the last video. We had three functions: increment, toString, and isEven. Let's take a closer look at increment and toString. Let's say that we want to combine these two functions, meaning for every integer x, we want to get a string representation of x plus 1. As we mentioned in the last video, functions in functional paradigm maps every single value of their input universe to a subset of values in their output universe. For example, for our increment function, each integer value from the input is mapped to an integer in the output. For toString, every integer from the input is mapped to one string in the output. Again, notice that toString only maps to a subset of the string universe in its output. So if the output universe of increment is same as input universe of toString, can we simplify our model? Can we somehow connect them? Why not? By simplifying our paradigm, we are not losing any information. But if we think more on this, doesn't it feel redundant that we have this middle step? Can't we just skip this part and directly go from input universe of increment to the output universe of toString? This is where functional programming and composing functions shine. From this paradigm, it seems that we are receiving an integer, apply the increment transformation, then we apply the toString transformation, and the result we get is our desired output, which is the string representation of the next integer that is passed as an input. But wait a second, isn't this familiar? Can't we just create a new function that step by step does this process of applying transformations for us? Yes, we can. And let's call this new function increment then toString. As we saw, calling our functions both ways are resulting to a same effect, meaning that we can simply take the first approach and replace it with the second, and vice versa. We talked about this in the last video. What I just said is one of the most powerful advantages of writing our code functionally. If we can simply replace functions with their definition, imagine all the optimizations compilers can do. This is called referential transparency. Getting back to our example, if we can define a generic function named compose, can we simply combine any two functions with the compatible input-output types? As a homework, try to define this compose function for yourself. How can you write a JavaScript function that receives an integer, calls the first argument with it, then calls a second argument with the previous calculation, and returns the result? I think I gave away the answer. But still, pause the video and try to code it for yourself. Done? Alright, let me show you how. So here, compose is receiving two functions as parameters and returns a new function that receives input x and do the fg on the x. Try to get used to this syntax. We are going to see this a lot from now on. In algebra, compose function is presented by this small o operator. Next, we will look into all of this in practice.